pinches and stones, as you saw. And that works really well, but now it has separated here in that joint here, so that I have to do some maintenance to weld that back in place. I have already done that on this side. I took the opportunity to put on some beads with a wear-resistant welding rod, and I can see that it is very much harder here. It's too, so it kind of slips sometimes, so it was better when it was the soft material. Anyways. But first my water cooler need to be fixed. This is my water cooler. It's a 12 volt electric pump, 5 liter of water in a plastic can. That's all. After 3 years now, this motor has given up for me, and I will just replace it. I have a duplicate of all the parts, so I will go into the sofa and show you how it works. So here are the parts for my water cooler, and I think strictly speaking it is not a water cooler. It is a water container, because what happens is that the water circulates out of the TIG torch back here and heats up the water in this plastic container. But it takes quite a lot of energy to heat up the water here, so I can weld for a long, long time. It very seldom happens that I need to change the water or take a very long break, because that is what one need to do to cool down this cooling water. The parts, this is the key for it. It's a 12 volt membrane motor. This one sells on eBay for 7 euro. It goes in here, of course. Screws onto there. This is the pickup line, suction line. Sucks up water here. It goes to the motor. And this one is only pressed in place. Those connectors there are slightly tapered. And there is a slightly tapered. So when they go in there and they get pressed in there, there is no leakage at all. That works fine. And then the whole assembly here is held together with the tie straps. There goes out to the TIG torch, shoop, and come back there, and really only drips it back into the water. A new motor. This time I will actually put on a small cooler. Cooler for the cooler motor. So I need to solder on some connecting cables there. Here it is, ready to be installed. This adapter here is printed in PLA, and that isn't waterproof, but the silicon tubing here helps with that. It's also great for sealing the connection to the torch. This adapter is available on Thingiverse. I will put a link in the description where you can find it. With some luck, you will have the right threads for the connection to the torch and for the plastic can. But I would guess in most cases they are wrong. I'll just check to see that it runs in the right direction. Yeah, it seems to do. Yeah, let's check that flow right there. So if I can pump it up here, we can measure it. Top it up. And there it is. There, a temperature probe, and what do we have? 20. Oh yeah, I need to fixate it also. There it is. So I'm ready with the TIG welding part of it. It has been strengthened up quite a bit here. Material added here on the tips. Doesn't look too nice here, but I will continue here with some stick welding on top of that. So, well, it doesn't matter. So what is the temperature now on the water? So what do we have? It was 30 we have. So it's not too bad. So I can live with that way. I can have it like up to 40-50 degrees without any problem. Yeah, it's back and fixed. I put some beads here with that wear resistant material. Wear thread, they are called. It doesn't look so terribly nice here, but it will be better when they have been shined up by the rocks. Anyway, so back to rock picking.